They leap. They dance. And even wink. These lovely creatures are center of attention wherever they go. The lions come in different colors and designs, usually based on ancient Chinese books characters. Master Siow Ho Phiew owns a company that makes them. He's also one of the most prominent lion dance trainers in Malaysia. A self-proclaimed lion enthusiast, Master Siow knows the history of lion dance inside out.
舞狮的缘起于中国，但是中国的狮也是舶来品，就是根据历史来说，在汉朝的时候是经过丝绸之路，经过西丝路，把这个丝从佛教文化带进中国，在中国这个地方落地生根，经过演变之后成为中国的地道文化。那今天这个文化随着我们的祖先，漂洋过海，从中国到世界各地去，无形中也把这个诗意带过。
He stumbled upon the lion making business out of necessity.
那我的狮头制作呢，也没有师傅教我的，那是当时因为不方便买到这狮头，唯一的呢就买了个拿了旧的狮头，经过观察和研究之后，开始着手做我自己的狮头。由于是玩票性质、业余性质的，慢慢的做一头、两头、三头，到后来成为我的职业。
He then refined the lions to make them lighter and more durable.
那到了后期，我们在舞狮里面发现这个狮头里面有很多缺点，那么我就开始着手去改革。那我们在马来西亚的制作品呢，都是用藤，现在我们看到这个藤的狮头，这藤的狮头现在我们看到这个是铝架，这个铝架过去呢是竹片，那么竹片第一它会蛀虫。 第二，它很容易在炽烈的时候会伤害到运动员的身体，所以我们改用了这个铝制。这个铝制的好处呢，还有就是能够加钉，所以它永远不脱落。那藤的好处呢，就是不会容易折断，而且再有弹性，很有弹性。Master
Siow is also bold in creating new designs of the lions, and one of his most popular designs is of batik prints.
这个巴蒂斯是当年在1992年。 我们当时立已经有，他想到，这个马中文化的建交里面是不是能够立下一个马中文化交流的形象？那他就给我提出，肖师傅，不然你来，把这个巴蒂的花纹射上这个狮头去。那我当时也是心里跟自己一直过不了那关，因为我说狮头是非常传统的，如果把巴蒂花加上去，万一人家不接受怎么办？那么我自己本身也很难接受。 不过东西总是要突破这个瓶颈，才有另外一个新的天地。那么我们在杆杆的创作之下呢，得到很好的反应，得到国家官方的认同，得到全世界诗坛界的认同。At
his workshop, Master Siow has a team of 15 full-time staff, most of whom are also his students. They each play different roles in handcrafting the lion heads, from framing, pasting, painting, varnishing and decorating. Most of Master Siow's employees have been working for him since teenagers. Among them is 9-year veteran Chong Chiu Sang. He's in charge of the framing of a lion head. Chong remembers well that the learning process with Master Siow was not without some scolding.
开始的时候会比较辛苦，辛苦了一点，但慢慢的还可以接受了。Terry
Tong also has been under Master Siow's wings for more than 8 years. A Sarawakian, Terry had traveled far to learn the art of lion dance from Master Siow.
因为我小时候我就是在报章上看到万盛行的一个广告，因为我对舞狮是相当有兴趣，所以就小时候嘛有个心愿，讲长大后我一定要过来这里帮忙肖师傅做工。
His main responsibility is painting a lion head.
其实画一只狮头是相当要有耐性、兴趣。上色当上这些颜色当然也是不可以太过离谱那些，当然要以传统来跟进。
Active in lion dancing, Terry splits his time between East and West Malaysia to participate in his troops, both here and in his hometown, Limbang.
我在这里也是有跟一班师兄弟成立了一支师团，也是刚才那位师兄讲的，三年了在这里。因为我本身在沙劳也是搞一支师团的，我是两边跑的。
哦，两边跑。那一边的舞狮发展又怎么样？跟西马那边？在东马会刚开始今年会比较辛苦一点，又加上经济的问题。当然是这条路是也是要走下去的，虽然是辛苦。Besides his students, Master Siow's children also help out with their father's business.
哦，因为来帮忙吧，就爸爸的事业，所以就抽空来帮忙。
His fifth daughter, Hui Yi, is very proud of her father's contribution to the art of lion dance.
很骄傲我有一个那么成功的父亲，他对舞狮界也做了很多贡献。For
Master Siow, he's just pleased that his hard work has come to fruition.
那我本身呢，也是很迷这个，所以也给自己讲了一句这个偏好，叫做诗痴。那我这诗痴呢，对是可以说是从 喜欢他和跟他恋爱到今天，应该是一个叫做开花结果。Inspired
by his teacher, Chong also wishes to preserve this particular Chinese art.
这也是中我们华人的艺术，就是想一代一代传下去。The
master's optimism about the future of lion dance is simply undeniable.
这点我根本都不担心这个传承，只要是文化的存在。 只要这种是一种良性的发展，这种文化的根永远是不会断的。而且在于我们万圣行来说，随着我学艺的学生，所谓学艺就是学舞狮、跳舞狮的，包括制作部他们都能够掌握到，所以根本我没有想到说这个会失传。因为想当年的我，也是因为了爱好而去追寻，有突破自己的天地。
And this kind of optimism drives Master Siow to continue to preserve, promote, and develop the ancient art. Lim Yuk, The Star, Malaysia.